I have been using the Aktiia 24/7 cuffless blood pressure monitor for over 2 weeks now, and I think having used it for that period of time, I've come to some conclusions about this particular device. As you can see, I'm currently wearing it on my wrist at the moment. Before I give a summary of what I think about it, so here is what I like about the Aktiia cuffless blood pressure monitor. It's optimized to do one thing and one thing only, and that is to measure your blood pressure. So on second thoughts, I'm thinking if you integrate this function into a smartwatch, would it really function as well as if you have it as a dedicated device? And I think because of the intricacies that go into making a smartwatch, I came to that conclusion that no, you probably wouldn't be able to optimize it for blood pressure. But we'll see how technology evolves with smartwatches that are beginning to measure blood pressure. Two, I think uninterrupted 24/7 cuffless blood pressure monitoring is the future. In other words, no matter where you are, what time of the day, you'll be able to get a blood pressure reading and know what is actually going on in your body. So that is a plus point. Three, it looks like a fashion accessory. As I said, you can see my wrist here. I have it on with a number of wristbands, and unless you're actually familiar with the Aktiia blood pressure monitor, you wouldn't know that I'm wearing a blood pressure monitor, so it really looks fashionable, which is a plus point. For it doesn't require that you take time aside and sit down and be quiet for about 5 minutes and hold the device up to the heart level before you take a measurement. So that's a plus point. It just continuously takes your blood pressure reading. Five, I think it's the future of ambulatory blood pressure monitoring, although it's not there yet because it only takes readings in 2-hour intervals. So there is still a lot more to do in this area. And finally, it's very lightweight, and you go about your daily activities and you don't actually know that you're wearing it unless you just cautiously decide that you want to take your blood pressure reading. So that's a plus point. So let's go to what I don't like about this device. So first, it requires you to initialize the device with a cuffed blood pressure monitor before you can start using the device. I would have preferred that you can just take the device out of the box and start wearing it. And that kind of gives me a bit of a concern about the algorithm and how it works. So it will be interesting to understand how the algorithm works and enables it to be as precise to your actual blood pressure as possible. I couldn't take my blood pressure reading using a cuffed blood pressure monitor and compare it with this particular device because of the intervals in which it throws out data. So the question for me was, when does this device take the blood pressure reading? And when it does, how many readings does it take an hour? Two, it requires you to initialize the wristband with the cuffed blood pressure monitor that comes with the kit every 30 days. So I really don't know why that is the case and the reason behind that, but it raises more questions for me about how the algorithm works rather than provide answers. Three, the app only displays blood pressure readings in 2-hour intervals only. So it would have been great if it could be narrowed down to readings every 30 minutes or reading every 15 minutes, because then you can actually associate whether you're eating and that has spiked your blood pressure, or whether you're busy doing some sort of activity in the house, and that has resulted in your blood pressure spiking. The readings are not granular enough for you to be able to deduct the reason why your blood pressure shot up at a particular time, because you could then reflect back and ask, what can I do better to ensure that my blood pressure doesn't spike that much? So, for example, we do know that your blood glucose can affect your blood pressure, and therefore, if you've taken a sugary drink in the last half an hour, you'll be able to see the impact that that has if you're able to get a reading, say, every 15 minutes. For the times where, if you look at the daily reporting, there are times where a whole 2 hours will go by where the app would say that there are no reliable readings. I'm just trying to comprehend how that is possible. Even if the readings are not reliable, it should still display with a caveat to say it's not a reliable reading. And then therefore you can correlate that specific unreliable reading with either before or after that unreliable reading was recorded. And you might be able to link it back to something like maybe you were running, or maybe something happened that prevented the device from taking any reading. So whether it's unreliable or not, it should display all the readings, or it should be able to provide some granular information about the readings that were taken and why it's not reliable. So number five, I know that this is still a new device on the market, but I think it's quite expensive for £200 or $220. Not many people will be able to afford this particular device. Number six, you cannot swim, take a shower, be in a sauna with this device, or take a bath with this device on. In other words, it's not waterproof, so you do not know what is happening with your blood pressure during these activities. So it will be good to see how the next iteration of this device is made to address this issue of not being waterproof. Another claim in the product literature is that it's most likely that it wouldn't take a blood pressure reading during normal workouts like running, skipping, walking. I don't know why that would be the case. If you look around 6 to 8 o'clock, you would see a spike in my blood pressure. And that is normally the time in the morning when I'm on my indoor bike riding. So that kind of gives me some confidence that it can take some readings, but there is a possibility that it might not. So here is another situation where, if you look at the screenshot here, while I was exercising on that particular day, it did not take a reading at all. And finally, I would have liked that it comes in different colors. So instead of just a black wristband, it would be good to have different colors like blue, pink, yellow, green, all sorts of colors. I think that would add more fun to the product. The Aktiia can even accessorize the wristband by selling it as an add-on, so you can have the basic color that it comes in, and then if you want to change the color, you pay a few more dollars or pounds to get the color that you want. So I think that would be an option for them to consider. I would say that it's not the ultimate blood pressure device yet, but I like it. I really like this device. I was quite skeptical about it, and it's something that I wouldn't hesitate to recommend to anybody who is trying to monitor their blood pressure throughout the entire day and night. For me, the ultimate device would be a device that you can just get out of the box, put on your wrist, and it starts reading your blood pressure straight away. There is no need for you to initialize it with a separate device or a separate cuffed blood pressure monitor. It just starts working as it is. And that device, so that it's best at what it does, it just records blood pressure only. It's not part of a smartwatch that does other things like recording your steps, like recording your fat burn, what you've eaten, and doing so many other things. It's just a blood pressure monitor, and it's so discreet that people wouldn't know that you're wearing it. And that's why I would put Aktiia at the top of the list of all the blood pressure devices that are on the market at the moment. So if you're interested in buying the Aktiia cuffless blood pressure monitor, why not use the link in the description below? You get 10% off your purchase, and I also get a cut so that I can continue to bring videos like this to you. In the time being, do everything you can to lower that blood pressure. I'll see you in the next video. Bye.